In this video, I'm going to tell you about how I made $250 in the first week of launching my AI app. I'm going to walk through what the app is, what are the different marketing techniques that I used, what are the different features in the app, and what are my future plans to grow it even more. This video is brought to you by No Code MBA. If you want to learn to build your own AI apps, very similar to what I'm going to share today, check the link in the description and check out No Code MBA's Building Apps with AI course, where you'll learn how to build AI apps using tools like Bubble, which this app itself is built on, connecting to AI APIs like OpenAI and Stable Diffusion. So the app is called BlogFox. Here we are in the BlogFox dashboard. And I built this app completely with Bubble, and I've connected it to Anthropic, which is similar to OpenAI, but a different AI model, which I found worked a little bit better for text generation. So this app essentially helps you create SEO-optimized articles, both from a YouTube video URL and also from a topic. And it also lets you batch generate articles if you want from a list of titles. So currently, the topic and batch generation are new features. So all of the revenue has come from people using it to generate blogs from their YouTube videos. In addition, you can manage your content. You can add a brand voice and style, which allows you to customize the final result of the blog and make it sound more like your own voice, which is something that I spent a lot of time building and tweaking the prompts to make sure that it worked well. We also have linking, so you can add links both from your own site, which are called internal links, or external links from other sites. And then the AI will automatically select the most relevant links and automatically add those links into the blog post. You can integrate directly into Webflow, WordPress.com, and WordPress.org. So WordPress.com is hosted by WordPress. .org is self-hosted or hosted on something like Bluehost. There's just a little bit of a difference there. So we built integrations using the API. So through Bubble, you can use the API connector on Bubble to connect to pretty much any other external service. So in this case, we're connecting to Webflow and WordPress. And that's the same thing in Bubble that we're using to connect to Anthropic to actually generate the blogs themselves. And then within the article itself with the blog, you can expand it if you want. You can publish it directly to your site. And then you can edit the blog directly here in the editor. And you also can leave feedback, and I can talk a little bit in a different video about how I built this feedback feature, because it's pretty cool and I think applies to a lot of different apps that someone might want to build. We also have an image generation prompt, which essentially takes the content of the blog post, converts it into an image prompt, and then runs that through Stable Diffusion to get an image that works pretty well for almost all of the articles that I've tested. And if it doesn't work perfectly, you can always regenerate the image. So I built in all of those features. And again, this is completely built on Bubble. There's no code, just built with Bubble, which is a no-code tool, and connecting to different APIs. Let me talk a little bit about how I got those first paying users. So when you launch an AI app, then on a lot of AI directories that you can post your app to. So one example of that is there's an AI for that.com. Another is Future Tool AI, I believe is what it's called. And there's a bunch of other AI app directories. Now, to post to some of these directories, especially the more popular directories, you do have to pay to be listed and advertised on them. So you can think of it kind of like an advertising fee to get users onto your app. I was a little bit skeptical when I first was thinking about how I was going to market this app and whether it was going to be worth it to actually pay to be posted on those platforms. So there's an AI for that.com, for example, I think cost me like $250. I'm not profitable yet on this business. I've still spent more on marketing and just generating the blogs than I have on the revenue that I've gotten back from that, but it's still early. In most businesses, you're not going to make a profit in the first day. I'm still really encouraged that there's actually been users who wanted to pay for this. So I paid to post on a few of these different directories, and that drove a lot of traffic to my website. So on the homepage of the website, before you log in, you actually can generate a blog post for free. So it's very similar to this. It'll say you have, you know, 3 free blog posts remaining. So I use a variety of different techniques to make sure that users can only generate 3 blog posts for free before they actually pay. So they can enter in a YouTube URL. It'll generate that blog post for them. And then in exchange, they just have to enter in their email address. So by doing that, I was able to get 400 emails. So about 400 people generated a free blog post through just those initial directory postings. I think that I've gotten like 1,500 unique people coming to the site, or maybe 1,000. So pretty good. About half of those people, or maybe a little less than half of those people, actually wanted to test it out and see how it worked. And then of those 400 people, 8 people have actually purchased. And they've done that just by using it. They use the app. When they run out of credits, it will prompt you to purchase more. And then in the billing section, you see the different plans, and the purchases came from actually a variety of different plans, a mix of $9, $29, and $99 a month. So no one's purchased the $299 a month plan yet, but those are the plans that people have purchased. And this is all set up through Stripe. So again, through the API connector in Bubble, I connected to Stripe to actually set up those plans. So that's kind of the marketing that I've done so far to get those first users. Now, when you market with those AI directories, at least what I found is the traffic will dry up after about a week. So the traffic now is significantly less than it was when I first launched on those platforms. So there's a few different options that I'm thinking through that I could do moving forward. So one is that you can pay to advertise more on those platforms, and I'm pretty confident that would get me more traffic. Now, it might not be necessarily the exact audience that I want to get in front of, and it might not be profitable considering, you know, like I mentioned before, it hasn't been profitable in terms of paying for those advertisement placements on the directories and getting the revenue back. So might not be something I want to do long-term. A lot of those people who are on those directories are just kind of interested in AI, just kind of want to see what the latest tools are. And things like that. The other thing that I was thinking of was kind of reaching out directly to different YouTube channels who I think this might be a really good fit for, maybe more educational channels. That's what I built BlogVox for originally, is No-Code MBA, and actually using it for No-Code MBA. One of the things that especially I found using either other tools that are similar or, you know, something like ChatGPT, is the quality of the writing just felt very robotic, felt like it was written by an AI. That's something that I spent a lot of time on BlogVox, is making sure that the final versions of the blogs that are generated sound like they were written by a human. Whether or not you use the presets, the brand voice and style, adding the presets can make it sound more like you. But even without this, it sounds, I think, really quite good, even in the default settings. And that was something that I worked a lot on to make sure that it was kind of differentiated from these other tools that I think you try it out once and it's just not that great. So I think reaching out to channels directly, some cold outreach, could be something that I want to try out. I could also try out Google Ads potentially for different related search terms. I've been thinking about potentially advertising in newsletters, which could be targeted towards both, you know, marketers or people who work in SEO, potentially. I'm not exactly sure what the ideal, user is yet, whether it's a YouTube channel, a marketer. So these are all things that I'm trying to figure out. And the way that I tend to think about marketing a new product is to just try a lot of different things. So spend a little bit of money in different channels and see what works best. And that's how I learn and find out what works best for getting new users. So hopefully this was an interesting overview of what I've done so far with BlogVox, how it got its first users, how it's making money. If you have any suggestions of anything that I should be doing to get more users or improve the product, if you try it out, you can go to blogvox.ai and try it out for free. Leave a comment below. If you want to learn to build your own AI app just like this, check the link in the description to go to No-Code MBA's Building Apps with AI course. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get future AI and no-code content here for free. And I'll see you in the next video.